G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. This is a Model Master model kit, Crom 1/8 scale, and just thought I'd show something different that you don't see every day. Let's have a little bit of a closer look. Jimmy Flintstone. It's just a little bit of a different kit that I thought I'd put on my YouTube channel. Just something that you don't see in the shops too much anymore. I'll just show you the image on the box there. And that's pretty much it. Nothing else on the rest of the box. Testers and Model Master. Let's have a look in the box. Here's the instructions. As you can see, they're pretty basic. Just only got 6 pieces for the model to go together. Here we have all the parts laid out. Just a quick overview of what you get in the kit. Alrighty then. Here's the main part of the body. Again, another big solid resin piece. I will apologize already because I actually snapped off a little bit of the ear there. I've still got the resin part, but that wasn't the company's problem, that was mine. I chipped it accidentally, but I can just glue that back on. But I'll just give you a quick look close up. His face is really well done. Fur's done nicely again. And like with a lot of these old resin kits, you do get a nice casting line down the side of the body. It runs down the leg there and over the fur. So you might need to get your little blade out or your Dremel to get rid of that. It's a bit nastier over this side, just a little bit. The actual detail on the face is really nice. The armor's nice. Belt's done well. There's no air bubbles in this. Got some nice sculpting on the thigh there, with his quads and his kneecap. And here's his left leg here. Again, it's nicely sculpted, but again, you also do get this casting line down the sides. You'll have to clean up. But as I said before, there's really no air bubbles in this kit, which is nice. Again, the other thigh sculpted nicely. His two arms, I don't see that every day. Two arms on one big casting block. Nice detail on his arms, no air bubbles again. Even the little chain around his arms there on both sides, or the rope. He's done really nicely, the little rings here are done really well. On my one here, there is a little bit missing there, but I'm not sure if it's broken off. Or if it just didn't sculpt, didn't come out that well on the cast. Show you the other side. And excuse me for not knowing the actual name of this weapon. I'll probably just call it a killing machine. It may not be its correct name. And you get his two hands sculpted onto the weapon. I'll just zoom in on his hands, and the sculpting on his hands is done really nicely. Got a couple of little veins running through his hands. Nice little detail and pattern on his weapon there. Again, there is a casting line running down the side, which really can't be avoided. Just depends on if it's going to be a bad one. or not so deep. His two hands are attached there. And again, there's no real air bubbles to be seen in this this piece either. And the bass. It's always nice when they give you a bass. It's just something that you don't really have to think about. It's always nice when you get the little imprints of the footprints again, as you've seen in some of my other videos. It's nice when they do that. It's an interesting texture on the groundwork here. Looks a bit mossy. Again, it's a pretty thick piece of resin there. Nice texture on the tree, or the bark. Even on the roots of the tree, there's nice texture on that. You really wouldn't have to do much to this base other than just paint it. You could add a little bit of your own moss and dirt if you wanted to, but it's not a bad base the way it looks on its own. There you have it, guys. It's your Model Master / Testers / Jimmy Flintstone 1/8 scale kit of Chrom. Thanks for looking, and I'll catch you later.